In this video, we will generate images of the subject from multiple perspectives using just a single input image. To do so, we will be using two different methods. First, we will use the QuinEdit Multiple Angle LoRA. With the help of its camera selector, we can generate images almost from any angle by keeping the subject still. Next, we'll move on to Apple's Sharp model to create a 3D Gaussian splatting representation of the subject. Using this 3D data, we'll then render images from different viewpoints with realistic depth and perspective. So, the workflow you see here is the default workflow for QuinEdit model with a file selected. This is the diffusion model selected, and then the Lightning LoRA to generate image in 4 steps. Then the text encoders and the VAE. And this is the multiple angle LoRA. Links to all the files are given on the left, including this multiple angle LoRA. The multiple angle LoRA released by FAL shows its capabilities of producing image from different angles using a single image. The sentences you see here are the prompts for different angles. And this is the camera distance from different angle, like a hemisphere. There are 3 hemispheres, close-up, medium shot, and wide shot. The square box in the center is the subject, and the green color triangles are the cameras. This means we can generate images of the subject from 32 different angles in a wide shot. Similarly, if we go closer to the subject, we generate a medium shot, and then it becomes red, which means we are too close to the subject. I hope you must have understood that red is inside, then yellow and green on the top. The LoRA can be downloaded from here. And I just now noticed a comfy UI workflow given on the same page. I opened the workflow in the comfy UI. It looks like the basic workflow with 96 prompt in it. So each prompt triggers a camera angle we saw just now. However, now we do not need these prompts. A new bug has been added in comfy UI. It says LoRA Manager Path Corrected. When I switch tabs, the path of my diffusion model changes automatically. The workflow you see has some minor changes, like this resize node, which is locked at 1024 pixels, which means this is always giving out an image with 1024 pixels. It could be the height or the width, whichever is longer. So, as I told you, we do not need the prompts because of this camera angle selector. This is from a custom node, which can be installed from the manager. Search for camera angle by author Nick Pittis. Just a note for safety, do not install nodes by unknown authors. I can trust this because there are multiple comfy UI nodes published by him. And here it shows the node gives out similar prompts we saw in the workflow from Hugging Face. So install the nightly version of the node and restart comfy UI. Have the node connected in this positive condition node. I will upload an image. So I have selected the bunny in Santa's costume, and now I will select the camera. This bright green triangle you see here is the nose of the subject. This means now I am straight in front of the subject. Now I am on the left of the subject, and now again in the center. So these boxes are the camera, and I have selected one of these boxes, which is now glowing. This represents the camera selected for a close-up shot. I can click it again to deactivate the camera. So I have selected this angle, and this, but this will give the same image as uploaded. This will be a different angle. And this will be a wide shot. As I move behind a subject, the color of the boxes changes. It goes from orange to red. So you will always know where you are. And now it goes from red to green. Now I am in front of the subject. This red color thing, which we usually use as a protection, indicates the camera is at a lower angle. Then it turns blue and green when we are on top. So I think this should be clear to you now. The hemispheres are of different colors, but it works in a similar way as we saw on Hugging Face. This is the direction green in the front, then it becomes red at the back of the character. These are the hemispheres, and these are the circles we saw on the box for identifying the height. These are prompts which will be used for generating images, and there is a clear button to clear all the selected cameras in the prompt. And this select filtered selected all. But this button should be used for selecting all the cameras. I will clear this and show you. Now, I want an image from the front of the subject. It should be a close shot image from a low angle. That's the filter, and then select the filtered camera. So if I select wide, which is the outer sphere, then I get one more in the low angle. Select elevated, and it brought two more because we had selected two spheres. I will select some of these, and then I will run the workflow. This resize node also gives out the height and width to the empty latent image, which keeps the resulting image in the same aspect ratio. You can change the resolution, but then it affects the other elements and objects added by the Quinn model in the image. It took 144 seconds on the first run, and these are the results. I like the image. The details are not great, but still. Producing a perfect head of the given bunny, with only two ears popping out correctly, is great. What are your thoughts on this? I tried doing something similar in one of my video. The title was Generating Multiple Images Using One Image. And then I saw this comment which said, make it using Zimage Turbo. It makes sense because the Zimage is good at generating realistic characters, so I responded to do so. But the challenge here is the Quinn Edit model is an edit model, which allows editing an existing image by maintaining other elements in the given image. The Zimage model is a straight text-to-image model, so it will not produce the given image in a different form without changing it. I have selected the Zimage diffusion model and a 3D anime Laura. And this is where I will put the image generated by Quinn Image. This is an image-to-image workflow, and the denoise value is 0.40, which should be enough. I made a video for beginners. If you need an explanation in this workflow, then the link will be in the description. Links to the file I am using are given here with GGUF models. And there are two, Laura. One is for the bunny image, and another is for the realistic image. The image will now go into the Zimage workflow. And for the prompt, I picked some keywords from the Laura page and added them to the prompt box. The seed ID in the Quinn workflow was fixed, so the process begins in the Zimage workflow. I added a node for cleaning VRAM, but then this workflow will ask for a new custom node installation. If in case you're not using Comfy UI Easy Use Node Group. Also, I don't see any other alternative with Comfy Core. I will use this debug node because KJ Node Group must be used by everyone. You can change it later. The results are generated, and I see a difference in her face. It looks like the smaller details are erased by the Zimage. I tried again with the image of this mouse cycling. The third node is the output from Zimage with the Laura. It is clear that the multiple angle Laura is working great. I wanted to add a detail Laura in the Quinn Edit workflow, but there are already two Laura chained after the model. I removed the prompt for the 3D character. Now we'll try a realistic image. And this is the image I have used. It was generated using a WAN video model. The results are really great. And kind of a surprise to me. In this image, the camera took out the roof of this train. Consistency remains the problem as always. The first image had a single row of seats, and here there are two. In this image, the details by Zimage are visible, Similar to the previous video, I have added the Save Image node. This image prefix will create a new folder in the given directory and save all the image in it. Now it looks clean. After saving the image, this is the path where the images are stored. Copy the path and use this node, put the path and run the workflow. It will start processing all the images in the given folder. You can directly make a connection, then it should get the path automatically. Or else connect it directly. Then all the images generated will be processed by Zimage at the same time. Next, I will try the Apple Sharp model to generate a Gaussian which does something similar. I am not an expert, but what I understood is that, in simple language, it creates a 3D space of colored 3D blobs, called Gaussians, using an image. The same we will be using to render an image from a different angle. The Gaussian splat is loaded and you can see the color blobs here. Also, a .py file has been created, which contains the details of the blobs. To make this workflow work, you will need two custom nodes. In the manager, search for Sharp. The author's name is PZ Nodes and the version is 002. The other node is Geometry Pack by the same author. Note the version, because I had a problem installing this, so you can stick with this version. Go to the website supersplat.com/editor. This was my previous attempt to understand how this works. I will reload the page to start again. Drag the PLY file generated, and it should be somewhere here. There it is. This grid and boundaries are not required. For someone trying this for the first time, they should be having patience to understand these controls. I am using the translate gizmo to move, and then using the mouse scroll to move forward. Use this fly camera to control using the keyboard. The button to control are W, A, S, and D. To move up and down, use the letter Q and letter E. This is similar to a video game. Once you are done and find the needed perspective, go to the render option and select the image. Save the file and use it in the given workflow. This was my previous attempt. I tried generating the woman's image from out of the window. But the reference image had a strong impact, and I got a flipped image. Upload the Gaussian's image in the first image node, and the original image in the second node. And let's see how it works. The prompt here has a LoRa trigger word, and then it says about filling up the black section with reference to the second image. This LoRa file was downloaded from Hugging Face. Link to file is given here. The reason it has a different name because the file name was in Chinese text. That's the only difference in this workflow. The rest are just common file and nodes. After a minute, I got the image, and I really like this image generated. So that was a quick overview and methods of generating images from different angles using Comfy UI. Yes, I did use a different website, but we did not pay anything. Workflow will be in the description, and images will be shared in the Discord group. I hope the video was informative, and I wish you an excellent day.